Sometimes life overseas, it comes around and it knocks you down, knocks you down. One look and I breathe. Hello, hello, welcome to my YouTube channel. I literally got these for the topic that we will be exploring today on, is it hard moving overseas? Is it hard living overseas? And the theme song is Knock You Down, and it's not about love, it's about life overseas. But like I say, you have to get right back up. And yeah, I guess talking about it is also a way of kind of getting right back up and making life work. And I just want to open this by saying that, I mean, in the book of Thessalonians, we hear God saying that to always be joyful, you know, to pray without ceasing, and to give thanks in all circumstances, because that is his will for our lives in Jesus Christ. So although I'm going to be talking about these hardships, the most important thing is realizing that there'll always be the valley, that's just as there's always the mountaintops. Anyway, let's get right into it. And I have my notepad again, where I'm making a bit of notes, because otherwise I'm just gonna ramble and just go on and on in circles. So it's better if I have this, and then I know the points that I need to be touching on. So here you are moving overseas. First thing is first, you're leaving your friends and you're leaving your family behind. So there's no way that could be easy, especially if you have close relationships with your family and friends. So that is the one hard thing. And not only are you leaving your family and friends, but you're leaving work, you're leaving familiarity, you're leaving a safe space, because what we know is safer than what we don't know. So you basically uprooting yourself. And because I'm going to leave this one part, I just want to say, when you move overseas, you are making the decision to uproot yourself from your friendships, from your family. So in a way, you're putting your existing relationships at a compromise. And that is not easy. You might not understand it at the time, but that's what's happening. So here you are uprooting. Uprooting, you get to a new country. It's almost as though you have to start again from rock bottom. You're now starting to have to figure out, where am I going to stay? Where's the grocery store? Where will I be working? How do I get to work? How do I find a car? What is the car financing options? What accommodation is available? And I remember for me, even just getting to New Zealand, being like, okay, I'm going to start looking for accommodation, and I'm going to find a nice, pretty bachelor, because that's normally what happens back at home in South Africa. You just find yourself a bachelor and you stay there, and you can actually afford it based on your salary. And then you move overseas, particularly New Zealand, because that's where I am, guys. And please know, for context sake, that I am staying in New Zealand, in Auckland, and it's regarded actually as the expensive city to live in New Zealand. I stand to be corrected. So you get here, and at first people were advising me to find commutes, and also confused, like, why that's when I was still working in the hospital, why are people suggesting that I find a commute? I am not looking for a commute, I'm looking for a bachelor. But these were people that already knew that, unfortunately, bachelors were a bit more pricey. So the alternative is staying and sharing with people. And now this also brings another element to it. You don't know the people that you might be staying with, so they might be good for you, and or they might not be good for you. So that's just another thing that is a bit of a challenge. And now let's say you found your accommodation, you know where the grocery store is, you know where the bus stop is while you're waiting to get a car. But the next thing is, you're trying now to find community. You coming into an environment where everybody else has pretty much established their friendships and a community, and you are the outsider. It was so cool because my friend said to me, my friend is Kosi Tyler, guys. But my friend, that matters, it's important that I say that. So my friend Kosi was just reflecting back on like how fearful she is of immigration, because she sees the immigrants within our home country, which is South Africa. So it's pretty much, you know, the same under different circumstances. You are cheering and the next thing is like, but where's my community? You know, so you struggle a bit finding community. And because we adults, it's harder to actually do find community and find friendships. Likely for me, I found a church and that church carried me for so long on the basis of community. Second thing to that is that I'm introverted. So in a way, I am still okay being indoors and so forth. But if you're somebody that is... Anyway, if you are somebody that is extroverted, well, yeah, I don't know, that might also kind of, you know, lay you into a shell that you otherwise not usually used to. And let's see what else is there. So without community, it kind of makes you feel a bit isolated. I feel also that the isolation feeling is inevitable, like you just cannot escape it. It will be there because you are isolated from your family, you are isolated from your friends. So whether you like it or not, it is automatically isolating. And the difference in culture between, for instance, South Africa and New Zealand is that South Africans become very curious and excited about people that are not from their community. Like, there's this excitement to shelter you, to hear more about you. Hey, where are you from? Oh my goodness. But here it's different. That excitement is just not a thing. And so that could kind of lead you into a depression span. Like, it could fluctuate with depression. Some people experience it severely, some more mildly, you know, and some it's hard to get yourself out of that space. Because for the longest time when I would be having my depression or my down moments, I didn't quite understand what was happening with me. Like, I was like, I don't know what is happening with my emotions. And it took me close to 2 years to realize, Sylvia, what is happening with your emotion is the heavy cost of immigration. So, yeah, but we're here now, still standing, you know, through God's grace and covering. And also, just being like a black immigrant in a Western country, you often find yourself to be a minority. And while you might not necessarily be treated like a minority, but you will feel it because that is just the reality of things. You would feel, again, this brings me back to isolation, because being African is cultural, guys. Being African is it's culture. Being African, as Kevin Fraser the comedian says, like, it's a feeling, and you don't often get that feeling in a lot of places. Not only that, but you feel it when you can't find hair products, you can't find, you know, things that are more in association or related to your culture, and you realize your culture is not important, your culture is not a priority, because this is a Western country. So that can also kind of have a toll on you. And another thing that is culturally different, and I guess this again kind of adds to what I'm saying, is there's this instantaneous joy and love that Africans have for life, or rather that black people have for life. You know, it's just there. It's just there. We're excited. We're like, you look so good. Like, oh my goodness, where are we going? Oh my goodness, this place is so much fun. You know, there's this just joy that we operate within, but that is just different. Yeah, there isn't just, I haven't seen it. Maybe some people do live like that, but particularly for me, I haven't seen it. That's why even... for me, I have to be mindful and conscious to just be excited about life. Wake up and like, Sylvia, remember the things that you truly love. You know, Sylvia, remember this is important to you. Sylvia, be happy. Laugh, man. You are a person that loves laughing. The other thing that's kind of culturally a bit of a, I guess these are all culture shock, is how kindness needs to be prompted. Like, kindness and Ubuntu is not spontaneous. So much that I feel awkward loving on people. I feel awkward displaying my love for others. It makes me feel like, oh, you're doing too much, you know. But then that's just how we live back at home. There's this dependability you know, that we hold each other higher, that we encourage one another, that we celebrate one another. But it's something a bit more different this side. There's a bit of a reservation and just this culture of independence. Like, we together, yeah, we together, yeah, we're friends, but hey, you know, let's just keep it at a distance. And you also struggle with mutual connections. My friend Karina King once said that one thing that connects people is struggle. So I guess coming to a country that's so laid back, where resources are there, everything is working, the roads are fine, work and is okay, you can work from the age of 16, you start driving from the age of 16, that there isn't much struggle. But in a way, that also is a disadvantage. It's both good. Man, who needs struggles? We're out here pursuing soft life. But then once there's no commonalities, then it's hard to connect because there's no mutual point of connectivity. So that's kind of a thing also that I find really hard. But at the core of moving overseas is really isolation. And it's just being in a different world, in a different space. It's literally starting over. You start to experience existential crisis for real, for real, for real, for real. And yeah, just have to keep your faith. Church has really helped me. And my faith in Jesus Christ, reading my Bible, meditating on scripture, praise and worship, it's really, really helped me. And like I said, connecting with other immigrants has been really, really helpful because we understand each other. We've all left home. We're all now here away from home. And yeah, but these have been the challenges for me personally. Let me tell you a secret. If you see somebody who's overseas, 1 month it's excitement, and then the other months you'll see we'll start deactivating Instagram, start just like no statuses on WhatsApp, just, you know. So yeah, it comes in waves and flows, and each person processes it differently. But if you know somebody overseas, please check on them. Don't lose the communication, and just know that they're probably feeling isolated. They're feeling disconnected, and in severe cases, people are struggling with depression that is so severe that they have to be on medication. So I guess this is also just to say that grass is not greener on the other side, that at the end of the day, life is life, and there'll always be hardships and there'll always be great moments. The idea is that we do go through the hardships and learn from them and come out better. And also just have this, you know, when you acknowledge that you are in a good space, and you just, I don't know, you just allow yourself to just be in that space and be happy and be grateful and make the most out of it. Because sometimes you can take for granted the good days, not forgetting that, hey, you know, if the wheel has to turn around, then it's going to be a mess. But yeah, guys, that is life overseas. And yeah, that is life overseas. I'm just going to end it at that. That is life overseas. That is life overseas. Likely I speak English, so I would imagine for people that don't know English, language also becomes a struggle in expressing yourself and communicating your needs. But if you are living overseas and you have some of your own struggles, please comment below and just share some of your struggles. I'll be there to reply back and just give some encouragement. And if it's something that I've also experienced, just, you know, acknowledge your feelings and your experiences. And if you'd like to come overseas and the certain things that you think you might struggle with and you'd like to ask me about them, also just feel free to comment below. Otherwise, thank you for your time, and see you next time as we talk more all things life overseas and how it knocks us down, but that we come right back up and just make the most out of life.